Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. So today we are going to learn commerce accountancy question and answers part 2. So watch the whole video to learn this all important content. And if you watch our complete series on this particular topic, you can crack any exam related to commerce. So by not wasting your valuable time, let's get started. And comment me how many of the answers you got correct. And don't forget to leave a valuable like or comment. Accountancy questions part 2. And if you haven't watched our previous video on this particular topic, you can click on the I button. Firstly, we will all learn from theory, because without basic concept you can't learn accountancy subject, and these questions are must known questions for all accounting students. So our first question is, what is debtors? Answer: a person who has to pay to business for getting goods and services on credit is known as debtors. I repeat, a person who has to pay to the business for getting goods and services on credit is known as debtors. A debtor is a person who owes money to the business. For example, loan taken from bank to buy car. It means you have taken loan from bank to buy a car. So now you are paying an amount to the bank in form of money or interest. So you have become a debtor of the bank because you are paying an amount to the bank. So you have become the debtor of the bank. Next, paying a business loan. Here you are paying an amount to your business. That means you have become a debtor of your business or your friend's business because you are paying an amount to the business. I hope you clearly understand this. Please note it down. Question number 2, what is creditor? Answer: a person to whom business has to pay for getting goods or services on credit is known as creditor. A creditor is a person to whom business owes money. Let us learn examples. People who loan money to friends. Here it is said that you have given loan to your friend. Now he is giving you money in the form of interest. So now you have become the creditor, because you are owning money from your friend. Next example, credit card company. I hope you clearly understand this. Please note it down. Question number 3, what is bad debts? Answer: an irrecoverable amount from a debtor is known as bad debts. It is a revenue loss to business. It means it is an irrecoverable amount which you have given to your debtor. Question number 4, what is capital expenditure? Answer: this expenditure is incurred to acquire fixed asset or to increase the value of fixed assets. It gives the benefit for a long period of time and it is non-recurring in nature. For example, purchase of machinery, extension of building, purchase of computer, etc. Question number 5, what is revenue expenditure? Answer: revenue expenditure is an expenditure from which no future benefit is expected, but having immediate or short-term benefit may be less than 1 year. It does not increase profit earning capacity of an organization. These are normal day-to-day operating expenses of a business, organization, and appear on a debit side of trading account or profit and loss account. For example, rent paid, salary paid, wages paid, etc. Question number 6, what is deferred revenue expenditure? Answer: an expenditure which is basically revenue in nature, but benefit of which is not exhausted within 1 year, is called as deferred revenue expenditure. Such expenditure is written off over number of years. For example, heavy expenditure on advertising, heavy legal expenses. Question number 7, what is solvent? Answer: if a person's assets are more than his liabilities. I repeat, if a person's assets are more than his liabilities or equal to his liabilities, he is called as a solvent. Solvent person is financially sound and is in a position to pay off all his debts. Question number 8, what is insolvent? A person whose liabilities are more than his assets is called as insolvent person. I repeat, a person whose liabilities आर मोर देन हिज एसेट्स इज कॉल्ड एज इनसॉल्वेंट पर्सन. सच पर्सन्स लाइबिलिटीज आर मोर देन हिज एसेट्स. क्वेश्चन नंबर 9. व्हाट इज गुडविल? गुडविल इज एन इंटेंजिबल एसेट दैट इज एसोसिएटेड विद द परचेस ऑफ वन कंपनी बाय अनदर. गुडविल इज द रेपुटेशन ऑफ बिजनेस एक्सप्रेस इन टर्म्स ऑफ मनी. गुडविल इज एन इंटेंजिबल एसेट. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10. व्हाट इज प्रॉफिट? व्हेन द सेलिंग प्राइस ऑफ गुड्स इज मोर देन द कॉस्ट प्राइस इट इज कॉल्ड एज प्रॉफिट. प्रॉफिट इंक्रीजेस द कैपिटल of the business. I know many of you know this concept. Question number 11. What is loss? Answer: when cost price is more than its selling price, it is called as loss. Loss decreases capital of business. Question number 12. What are assets? Most important concept in accountancy. Answer: any physical thing or right owned that has a monetary value is called as assets. The ownership of the assets must be with the business unit. For example, land, building, patents, computers, furniture, etc. are all assets. Question number 13. What are liabilities? Answer: amount payable by the business to others is known as liabilities. It is a debt or amount due from the business to others for the benefit received by the business unit. For example, loan taken, creditors, bank overdraft, outstanding expenses, etc. are all liabilities. Let us learn objectives. Question number 14. Surplus of income over expenses is? Option A, profit. Question number 15. In which basis of accounting actual cash receipts and actual cash payments are recorded? Option C, cash. Question number 16. Amount which is not recoverable from customers is known as? Option A, bad debts. Question number 17. Accounts must be honestly prepared and they must be disclosed. All material information is known as? Option C, disclosure concept. Question number 18. A commodity in which a trader deals is known as? Option A, goods. Question number 19. Dash means a reputation of a business valued in terms of money is? Option A, trademark. Question number 20. Brief explanation of an entry is called as? Option B, narration. Question number 21. The immediate recognition of loss is supported by principle of? Option A, conservative. Question number 22. An act of exchange of things or services between the two parties is termed as? Option C, transaction. Question number 23. Of the following types, which would be increased by a debit? Option C, assets and expenses. Question number 24. One of the following rules used to record business transactions is? Option C, double entry, bookkeeping. Question number 25. The trading and profit and loss account is also called as? Option C, income statement. Question number 26. Which of the following principles assumes that a business will continue for a long time? Option D, going concern. Question number 27. Generally, the duration of an accounting period is of 12 months. Question number 28. The sum of liabilities and capital is 1. Assets. Question number 29. The amount drawn for personal use is called as 1. Drawings. Question number 30. Which of the following is entered in cash book? Option A. Only cash transactions. Okay, everyone, I hope you clearly understand these questions. So learn, practice, and revise them. And if you found our efforts helpful, please support us by subscribing to our channel. So that's it for today. Have a nice day, and thank you so much for watching.